Hi everyone, I'm Alex Noonan. I'm a developer advocate here at Dagster Labs, and today I'm going to build a project where we fine-tune an OpenAI model using Dagster. Fine-tuning is a process where you take an existing LLM model and then train it on a specific data set so you can customize its behavior and get better results. So the benefits of fine-tuning. Number one, you get customization. So you tailor the model's behavior for a specific use case, goal, or voice. Next, you get cost efficiency. One, you'll save on tokens by having better structured prompts. And two, you'll use less computationally expensive models that are refined for your use case. So you'll save money while also getting better results. And finally, output control. You can define what the output is supposed to be from the model, so you have control over the format and the style of the model's output. Fine-tuning will be familiar to you if you've done machine learning in the past. And at a high level, the process is very similar. Number one, you have data collection and preparation. Then you have the training configuration. Then you actually have the training. Next, you have evaluation, which is arguably the most important step. And then additionally, you have iteration and improvement, and finally deployment. Using Dagster for fine-tuning simplifies your job as a data engineer by providing you the right abstractions and enhancing observability, which is essential if you're deploying AI applications to production environments. By leveraging software-defined assets, you can have your training data, validation data, and the model itself as assets. So you get granular level metadata, evaluation history, and the lineage of the asset and how it connects to your wider data platform. You can also ensure data freshness by automation conditions and leveraging freshness checks. For monitoring and observability, you get detailed resource usage tracking. Dagster has integrations with Gemini, Anthropic, and OpenAI. So you can use those services and emit metadata into Dagster to show your usage and identify bottlenecks. And finally, you get intuitive logging and observability through the Dagster UI. For testing and quality, you can create unit tests for the pipeline modules, and you can leverage asset checks for your training and validation data sets to make sure they're in the right format, and for the model itself to evaluate it to make sure it performs better than the baseline model. And for this project, I'm going to build a simple fine-tune model using OpenAI based on publicly available Goodreads data. And at the end of this, we will evaluate our model compared to the base one. Let's jump into it. Here we are in VS Code, and you can follow along with the tutorial that's in the description. And we're gonna start out importing all our dependencies here. Now that's out of the way, we're going to create an external asset for the Goodreads dataset. And for our first asset, we're going to read in our Goodreads graphic novel dataset and then ingest it into our DuckDB database. And our next asset is going to be for the authors. And this asset is going to be very similar from the graphic novels one above. Now that we have our raw data in place, we need to do some feature engineering on it. So we're going to create an asset here that categorizes the different books. And for that, we need to pull in our different categories that we have in our constant files. And then we're going to query all the books, the categories associated with them, and then we're going to map them together. So we have all of our books labeled by their category. And for our next asset, we're going to create an enriched graphic novels asset that we'll use for the basis of our training and validation data set. So in this asset, we'll have all the titles, the author's description, and the categories for all our graphic novels. Quick note, when you have the asset dependencies inside the function parentheses, like that's when you're telling Dagster to use the default IO manager, which is useful for use cases when you have standardized input and output. And the dependencies will still show up in your asset graph. Next, we're going to create a helper function to generate the prompt record, which includes a system prompt and a user prompt, and then there's an assistant prompt at the bottom. So for our next asset, we're going to create our training file. And for that, we're going to take in our enriched graphic novels data asset we created earlier. We're going to take a sampling of these, and then we're going to generate prompts for each of those sampled book values and write those to a JSON file. And then our next asset here is going to be for our validation file. And this process is going to mirror the training file. And that should be no surprise, since in order to test what we train on, it needs to be the same, but using different samples. We need to be able to validate that our training and validation files are good. So we're going to create a helper function that we'll use in our asset checks for those assets. And what we're looking for here is to check to make sure that each message has the right keys, has a valid role, and has a valid content. And if any of the messages aren't in the proper structure, the asset check will fail, otherwise we'll pass. And then next, we're going to create the asset check for the training file, which will use the helper function we just created. And then we're going to do the same thing for the validation file. Now that our assets are validated, we need to create assets to upload the training and validation file to OpenAI for the purpose of the fine-tuning. Now we're on to our final asset, which is the fine-tuned model, which is going to include the uploaded training file and the validation file. And then we're going to get the OpenAI client and create the fine-tuning job with our validation files, the model we use, and then the suffix for this model, which will be in the name. And then we're going to log the job that is running to create it. This asset is going to run for a little bit, so we're going to have this statement here, this while statement to track as the asset is running, and then to break the loop if it's canceled or fail to end the asset. And then we're going to return the output metadata, which is the model's name. Now that we have our fine-tuned model, we need to create an asset check to validate that it works and that it performs better than the base model. And then this helper function here is going to structure the question that we ask the model based on the messages. And here we're using OpenAI's chat completion API, and we're structuring the messages for the system prompt, the user prompt, and as part of the evaluation process, we want a standardized response. So here we're going to define a JSON schema that all the responses from the chat needs to be. And for our final model, we're going to compare the accuracy of the base model against our fine-tuned model. And to do that, we're going to categorize a sample of values from the validation data set, and we're going to see which model performed better. And then if the fine-tuned model performs better than the base model, the asset check will succeed. Otherwise, it'll fail. And now that all our assets and asset checks are created, let's build out our definitions file. So we're going to load our assets and external assets into the definitions file. We're going to add our asset checks as well. And then we're going to define our OpenAI resource and DuckDB resource. Now that's done, we're going to create a new virtual environment, activate it, and then we're going to install the dependencies in this project and then fire up Dagster, and we're ready to go. So here we are in the UI, and let's start by materializing the ingestion assets. Next, we're going to materialize the feature engineering assets for book category. Then we'll do the processing. So we're going to enrich our assets. Now on to the training and validation file creation. And the asset check for the file format passed. Now that our training and validation files are good to go, we're going to upload them into OpenAI. Now, the moment we've all been waiting for, let's actually materialize our fine-tuned model. So if we navigate to the runs view, we can actually see this materialize. This takes 8 or so minutes to run. And so the asset materialized, now it's doing the asset check to check the validation. So now that our fine-tuned model asset check passed, our model is created, and on evaluation, we have seen that it's more accurate than the base model, with our model coming in at 83% accuracy and the base model at 63%.
Now, I hope you enjoyed that demonstration of fine-tuning OpenAI models with Dagster. Now, the link to the tutorial for this is in the description below, and make sure you subscribe to this channel and follow us on all our socials, so you don't miss any updates. Thank you.